President Uhuru Kenyatta has exuded confidence that his government will extend coverage of the ongoing mindset education through the Ministry of ICT, Innovation and Youth Affairs to cover in the entire country and catalyze youth transformation through the use of technology. The head of state at the same time okayed mental health education at a time the country has been on economical pressure following the COVID-19 outbreak.
President Uhuru Kenyatta has called for the implementation of mind education as a way to scale up psychosocial support for the youth. The Ministry of Health, Ministry of Education and the Ministry of ICT, Innovation and Youth Affairs have been tasked with the objective of implementing the program in Kenya. Kenya has been grappling with deterioration of the mental health conditions among the citizens, especially amongst the youth specifically during the COVID-19 pandemic. This has led to increased cases of self-destructing behavior among the youth. The government, in its efforts to improve this, put up a mental health task force in December 2019 under the Ministry of Health to come up with ways to scale up the psychosocial support needed. Today, the International Youth Fellowship has been tasked to provide necessary support to the task force. Speaking on behalf of the President, the Cabinet Secretary of ICT, Innovation and Youth Affairs, Joe Mucheru, indicated that the intervention of the government's training life skills among the youth cannot be effective without psychosocial support.
The task force was to assess Kenya's mental health systems and consider the threats to mental well-being, such as substance abuse, sexual and gender-based violence, child abuse, and neglect. As we implement the recommendations that the task force has submitted, I invite you to consider scaling up the mindset program in Kenya to help us strengthen psychosocial support for the youth.
With the new education curriculum still taking shape in the country, the president has also lauded the mind education program as a solution to the moral and character decay among the youth.
This curriculum aims to strengthen both cognitive and psychosocial skills. This includes communication and collaboration, critical thinking and problem solving, imagination and creativity, citizenship, learning to learn, and digital literacy. This transition to the competency-based curriculum presents an opportunity for the mindset training program to enrich this new curriculum.
The founder of International Youth Fellowship, Dr. Ongso Park, while speaking during the meeting, indicated the greatest problem has lack of contemplation among the youth globally, with Africa being the greatest affected.
And so, you know, the first thing that I would like to teach the Kenyan youth is about contemplation, thinking deeply. And so ever since we started this mind education program in prisons, they have changed a lot. And put a clean and radiant heart and a heart to contemplate. And so once they have the healthy contemplation, and I know for sure that Kenya will be the best in problems of character.
The virtual meeting was organized by the Office of the President and was attended by the founder of IYF and Mindset Education in South Korea, Reverend Dr. Ongso Park, Youth CS Joe Mucheru EGH, Mr. Julius Korir CBS, Principal Secretary Raymond Ocheng, Secretary of Youth Affairs, State Department for Youth, Ministry of Education, Professor George Magoha, Ruth Kagia, Deputy Chief of Staff, Office of the President, and Yon Kim, Chairman, IYF East Africa.